Praise God. William Branham came. Oh, glory be to God. Hallelujah. 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 William Branham came. I remember. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. When he was moving in the, Moses was moving in the wilderness, as he was pulling his people out of Egypt, there was a pillar of fire that led them by day and cloud by night. And in this age, nobody has had that light appearing. But in the ministry of this son, William Branham again, blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Pointing us to tell us, out of this darkness, this is the way. Follow this. This is the man that has the message. Vindicated by that light. That's why we believe that that man is the seventh angel. He fulfilled it without controversy. Thank you, brother. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. So it's only normal that in his characteristic, the age will close with a prophet. A prophetic ministry with such vindication that you can't doubt it, can't fault it for everyone that is called of God. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And remember that we call them star messengers. And what is a star supposed to do? The star shines light. Always remember, I think it's Matthew chapter 2. Matthew chapter 2, verse 1. It says, now when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem. Not Igbo land, though. It's Middle East, not Eastern Nigeria. Men from east, not Igbo people. But they are very wise. Igbo people are very wise. If you're an Igbo person here, clap for yourself. Praise God. They are very, very wise. They were saying, verse 2, where is he that is born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east and are come to worship him. They saw his star. They saw his star. They are wise because they were astrologers. They are wise because they are studying what is happening around them. And one thing is that the heavenly bodies inform of us things that happen on the earth. Although God has banned it, we are not to go to astrologers. Praise the Lord. Because it has served his purpose. It has served his purpose. Now we go to the Holy Ghost. You want to know anything, get the Holy Ghost. And the Holy Ghost has caused us to know what will happen prophetically through the book, the Bible. So you won't leave the Bible now and go to astrology. God does not want that. If you want to know anything, go to his prophet. That's why he has a prophetic ministry. Don't go and start looking at stars. Go and let the Holy Ghost speak to you. But at that time, they were studying the stars. And they saw a particular star. That each time that star appears, there is a king that is born. And that king must be a special king that will be announced by a star. And according to their study, the star began to move. They knew it was going somewhere. And they followed that star. And this that star. Remember, there were other stars. So there are millions of stars. So, and they're all giving one form of light or the other. Hey. I wish I have time to talk more on this. They are stars. So everywhere they are stars. They are giving one form of light or the other. Each time you look up in the night, you will see them bing, 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 everywhere. They are speaking, spiritually speaking, letting us know every star is a ministry, is a pastor, is speaking of different pastors, that have one light or the other to shine. But among all those stars, we are all stars. So, Oral Robert is a star. Billy Graham is a star. There are local stars. There are international stars. There are worldwide stars. Oyedepo is a star, very bright one. Adeboye is a very, very big star. He's a star. Oh. He has a light, he's given forth. Mwaka is a star. He's a star, he's giving off a light. The Pope of Rome is a star. Archbishop is a star. I want you to understand Bible. Praise the Lord. They are all stars. But wise men from the east, they looked at a particular star. Oh, hallelujah. I omitted one star. Moses Alu is a star. While they were looking at all the stars, they suddenly saw a particular star that looked different from the other stars. The other stars were static. The other stars, they were static. They remain in one place. This is what they believe. This is what they have. But a particular star is shining a way that attracted the wise men. Watch it. And they know that that is the star of a king. Where is the king? That is the purpose of the star. The star is to lead you to where the King of Kings is. And they followed that star and they found where Jesus was. And in this age, God raised a star messenger by the name of William Branham with a unique ministry. He's the only one that pointed us to Christ the Word. The only one that pointed us to Christ the Word. Don't mind the inter-message believers. Some of them that Satan has flooded this inter-message with carnal preachers that instead of following the star and for the star to lead them there, the star has led them to where Christ is. They are still busy, the star. They are busy worshiping the star. Oh, the star. Oh, the star, William Branham. Oh, Brother Branham say. Oh, Brother Branham say. Until some of them don't even read the Bible again. They read only the sermon books of William Branham. They listen to only his tape. It's not error. It's the same spirit that started from the first church age. In sevenfold onslaught against the message. How can somebody say he had what William Branham is saying? And instead of coming to the Bible, you are holding on to some quotes. They didn't hear him. Because the idolaters always looking for somebody to worship. Always looking for somebody to worship. And for their folly to be made manifest. If Elisha followed Elijah, the evidence that he understood Elijah, after Elijah left, the power that Elisha demonstrated came on Elisha double fold. Why are you saying Brother Brown, and one single power you cannot demonstrate? Because there is no healing in the name of William Branham. There is no deliverance in the name of William Branham. There is no salvation in the name of William Branham. He is a star. He's a messenger with a message from his master. Rebecca was not to follow Eliezer after she has seen Isaac. Eliezer's business was to bring Rebecca to who? To Isaac. And then he steps aside and leaves the two of them to relate. That is his ministry. Anything beyond that is idolatry. Staged by Satan to mess up this glorious message. We're no longer attracted. Nobody wants to hear us. They think we are cults. Nobody wants to hear us. But I thank God in 1990 that God told me he will use me to beautify this entire message. 1990. That leprous woman is beginning to be beautiful again. People are now hearing the entire message worldwide. Worldwide. Praise the Lord. God always has his elect. Satan can never defeat the purpose of God. Elijah thought he was the only one. Until God told him there are 7,000. Satan think that he has finished this entire message. But there shall be a resurrection. I told you Samson's hair began to grow again. Samson's hair began to grow. Samson's hair is growing again. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Therefore, he fulfills the seven-star messenger, fulfilling Revelation chapter 10 and verse 7. But in the days of the voice of the seventh angel, Revelation chapter 10 verse 7, when he shall begin to sound, the mystery of God should be finished, as he had declared to his servants, the prophets. Just for the purpose of emphasis, because somebody is always hearing me for the first time. That scripture said, the mystery of God should be finished. And what is the mystery of God? Ephesians chapter 3 tells us that mystery is the salvation of the Gentiles. The church, the gospel rejected by the Jews moves, according to Acts chapter 30, Apostle Paul says so, moves to the Gentiles. And the eyes of the Jews blinding. And the gospel comes to us. It's a mystery because we who were called dogs, we who Jesus said he did not come to the lost, but to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. He warned his disciples, even initially, don't go to any Gentile place. I didn't come for them. The Syrophoenician woman begged to heal my daughter. He said, I don't give the children's meat to dogs. But now something has happened that has now made us to even take a higher place. Fulfilling the first shall be the last, and the last shall be the first. The mystery of how this is achieved shall be rounding up. Sometimes the entire message believers, they'll begin to quote and say the mysteries. He said, when, listen church, listen. And listen carefully. I have been in this thing I am preaching since 1989. And I have been preaching now as a pastor since 1998. And I have tried to study after I became a pastor to know that I'll be responsible for what I teach the people. If I mislead them, I will pay for it. I have tried to be careful in teaching the people based on what is my conviction. I am not a copy typist. I won't say anything until I am convinced it is the truth. And even if I find out later on that what I thought was the truth is contrary, I will come here without shame quickly and correct myself. Listen, a lot of people mistake statements, misuse statements made by William Branham. And they begin to make statements like, in the days of the voice of the seventh angel, when he shall begin to sound, he said, all the mysteries will be revealed. Then they went further to say that the seventh star messenger will reveal all the mysteries of God. Now, that statement is not correct. Listen very well, because that scripture says, in the days of the voice of the seventh angel, when he shall begin to sound, he said, the mystery, it is one mystery. Can you see it there? Eh? Is it mysteries or mystery? It's one mystery. The mystery of God should be finished. And take note again. He didn't say that the seventh angel will come and reveal all the mystery. He didn't even say the seventh angel will reveal the mystery. We finish the revelation of the mystery. He didn't say so. He only said in the days that he will begin to sound, in the days of his ministry, he said the mystery should be finished. In the days of his own ministry, whatever is his ministry, hallelujah, because the mystery of God did not start with William Branham. It started as soon as the gospel moved to the Gentiles. And everyone had a part he was playing. All the messengers had a part they were playing in that one singular mystery. The part that William Branham will play will conclude that mystery. The part that William Branham will play. Not that William Branham will come and reveal all the mysteries. One mystery. What is the mystery? I have taken time to explain it. That mystery is in Romans chapter 11. Can we read it again for emphasis? Hallelujah. Okay, for the purpose of the Bible study, let's see the way Apostle Paul put it first. He put it first in Ephesians chapter 3. Let's read Ephesians chapter 3 from verse 1. With old members, you should be familiar with the scripture, but I discover somebody is always hearing us for the first time. So we don't confuse them. But you go to our tape archives and listen to our messages. Ephesians chapter 3. For this cause, verse 1, I, Paul, the prisoner of Jesus Christ, for you Gentiles, if you have heard of the dispensation of grace of God, which is given to you, what? The dispensation of the period that he will be a star messenger to to one of the seven church ages, official church age. It was a dispensational period, and he had that dispensational ministry. How that by revelation he made known unto me the mystery. Is it mysteries or mystery? Is it mysteries there or mystery? One mystery. As I wrote for a few words, whereby when you read, you may understand my knowledge in the mystery of Christ, which in other ages was not made known unto the sons of men, as it is now revealed unto his holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit. What is the mystery? Verse 6. That the Gentiles should be fellow heirs and of the same body and partakers of his promise in Christ by the gospel. I read it again, verse 6. Everybody, shall we go? That the Gentiles should be fellow heirs and of the same body and partakers of his promise in Christ by the gospel. That is the mystery. Praise the Lord. But what is mysterious about it? The Gentiles coming in. That is what Apostle Paul explained in Romans chapter 11. That is where you get the mystery. Verse 25. Oh, praise God. Praise the Lord. Okay, verse 24. Verse 24. For if thou wert cut off out of the olive tree, telling the Jews, there is the olive tree, and there were branches of that olive tree. For Jesus said, I am the vine, and ye are the branches. Now, Israel was cut off so that we will be grafted in. If thou were cut out of the olive tree, which is wild by nature, and were grafted contrary to nature into a good olive tree, how much more shall these, which be the natural branches, be grafted into their own olive tree? So the emphasis here is, it says that you are grafted into that olive tree, is a contrary to nature. I've explained it before. Contrary to nature. That is where the mystery is. God caused me to understand it this when I was studying. It excited me so much. I didn't know when I jumped up from my bed where I was reading. We know about grafting. how that you can pluck the branch of a citrus tree, scrape another citrus tree, and graft it in there. When you graft it to that trunk of that citrus tree, it says, according to nature, that branch that you put in there will come there and grow. It will take nourishment from that tree. All the life it receives from that tree. And it will grow. It will have life from that tree. But when it comes to the time to bear fruit, according to nature, the fruit it will bear the fruit of the tree that you cut it off from. It will not bear the fruit of that particular tree that you graft it in. But if the original one branches out from that tree, that original one, when it is time for the fruit, it will bear the fruit of that tree. But the one that was grafted in, according to the law of grafting, it is natural. It is so. When it is to give forth fruit, it will give forth fruit of the tree that it was cut off from. But Apostle Paul now say, you were cut off from a wild olive tree, and you came to a good olive tree and graft in. He said, contrary to nature. It means, instead of you now to bring forth the fruit of where you came from, the mystery there is that you will begin to give forth the fruit of the tree that you have been grafted in. That is the mystery of salvation of the Gentiles. That is the mystery of the salvation of the Gentiles. In the days of the voice of the seventh angel, that mystery that started with Apostle Paul in Acts chapter 13 in the Ephesian church age, it will be rounding up complete salvation of the Gentiles in the days of the voice of the seventh angel that rounds up the salvation for the Gentiles. Praise the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. You have to catch that to understand what God is doing in this age. So it becomes a seven-star messenger according to Revelation chapter 10, verse 7. Because after seven, there is no more age. The building is complete. The mystery is complete. The program for salvation is complete. After that, it's the rapture. So that you know how close we are to the end. We are in the last of the last days. Oh, glory be to God. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. And it is the overcomers of this age. The overcomers of this age. The Bible tells us, we will rule with Christ. We will rule with Christ in the millennium. Because after this, it is the rapture. And take note, please, that this closes the Gentile age. It closes it. Why? Because there is something he said in Matthew chapter 24. Matthew chapter 24. From verse 23. Let me emphasize this here. Then is future. If any man shall say unto you, lo, here is Christ, or there, he said, believe it not. For there shall arise false Christs. Not false Jesus, so. False Christ, that means false anointed. False anointed ones. And false prophets, and shall show great signs. Is it not the age of signs and wonders? Great signs and wonders. In so much that if it were possible, they shall deceive the very elect. signs and wonders. There is an apostle at Awuchi. Apostle prophet. I'm still waiting to get that clip, but several people called me when they saw it. That he showed my picture and showed my picture and showed the church. And showed Brother Moses, who sits on a wheelchair in front here every service. And he was saying that that man, Pastor Moses, there in Lagos, he's a good preacher, quite all right. He acknowledges I'm a good preacher. He said, but he's there condemning everybody. He said, and he's preaching. He said, and yet in front of him there, he said, there is a cripple sitting down there. If he says he's a preacher, then where is the power? Let him raise that man. And then he began to do some demonstration and anoint him. And of course, the blind people he's leading will be clapping hands. Because they don't know that Babalawo can do that. They don't know that the Bible says there shall be false prophets. There shall be false Christs. Praise the Lord. And they don't know that the proof of a ministry is not in the demonstration of their power. Because Matthew chapter 7 says, not all that say, Lord, 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 shall enter into the kingdom. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. I am not speaking against the power he demonstrates. I thank God for the anointing. Apostle Suleiman, I am not speaking against the grace of God upon your life. I have only said two things concerning you. That you are not an apostle. That you are a prophet. Stop bearing apostle. It is contrary to the scripture. And secondly, I told you, I say, you mentioned that William Branham went in error. That you are among those re-echoing that he ended up badly. He should have stayed in miracles, signs and wonders like you are doing. But that he went into teaching. And because of it, God got angry and took him away. What was the teaching, Apostle Suleiman, that William Branham was preaching? Because he said, God is not three, he is one. Because he said, it is wrong to commercialize the gospel. All of you that have made merchandise of the gospel, he told you, the Bible said, freely we receive, and freely we give. Apostle Suleiman, listen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. I am saying, what is the message that is following your miracle, signs and wonders? What is the miracle? What is the message? What is the message? If there is no message, then I liken you to Jannes and Jambres in the Pharaoh. Jannes and Jambres. In the palace of Pharaoh, when Moses came, Moses had a message. They did not have a message, but they had all the power Moses had. What is your message? When you are there, people sitting down there with trousers, sisters, painted and wearing and dressing anyhow. How many people have you drawn to Christ or drawn to yourself? That is the ministry of grace. And for your information, we have the power here too. I say we have the power here too. I say we have the power. Hey, we have the power. Hallelujah. The power we have here is higher than the power to raise the blind, to give eyes to the blind. The power we have here is higher than the power that we restore the sight, that we make the cripples to walk. The power we have here is the power that we make a sinner to become a saint. That is the power we have here. That's the power we have. Women come to this church and they drop all the fashions of this world. They go to your church and they learn the latest fashion in your church. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. We know where we stand. Don't challenge us until you have something reasonable to talk. When we talk, repent and don't challenge us. Don't challenge us. We know what we are saying, and we are not preaching to everybody. The foundation of God standeth sure. Having this seed, the Lord knoweth them that are his. They are the ones we are talking to. My sheep, hear my voice. The Lord Jesus Christ says so. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Go and get the Holy Ghost. Go and get the Holy Ghost, pastors. Go and get the Holy Ghost. If you have the Holy Ghost, you will not be angry with what I am saying. You will repent. I'm getting angry. This man. Till they are threatening me up and down. You must manifest which spirit is in you now. Because he was a murderer from the beginning. You are of your father, the devil. All of you that are looking to kill me because of what I speak. It's the same spirit that went after Jesus. If not, bring Bible and tell me what I am saying is wrong. And don't get angry. Because I tell you, stop commercializing the gospel. It is wrong for a pastor to have headquarters and branches. Your day, your wife, she stands at the pulpit and preach. William Branham brought us to the scripture to see that the woman is not permitted to teach, nor usurp authority over the man. Go and deordain your wife. Go and deordain your wife. Go and deordain your wife. Or you think my wife doesn't know Bible? Or you think my wife cannot talk? After all, I learned how to talk from her, isn't it? Ebele, I think I'm very shy. Praise the Lord. I love young people who love to serve God. But I also like them to be humble. Many of them are too proud because of a grace they receive. And I hate pride. Whatever we have is by God's grace. When you begin by God's grace, begin to carry shoulders as if you are something. Then I know Satan has taken over that body. May they repent in the name of Jesus. And let Apostle Suleiman be sincere. Is it every sickness that comes to his church that receives healing? Is it every problem that comes to his church that receives solution? If it even before God, is it everybody that comes to God face to face that God will heal him? Didn't Jesus go to the pool of Bethesda? Not be one person he healed. He leave the rest there. So go and challenge him. Why didn't he heal everybody? Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. I was going to read a scripture. Chapter 24, Matthew. Let me read it again. Verse 23. Then if any man shall say unto you, lo, here is Christ, or there, believe it not. For there shall arise false Christ and false prophets, and shall show great signs and wonders. In so much that if it were possible, they shall deceive the very elect. The elect cannot be deceived. Let the elect say, I cannot be deceived. Say it again. No, say it very loud. Tap your neighbor, say, look, I am elect. I cannot be deceived. Verse 25. Behold, I have told you before. He said, wherefore, if they shall say unto you, behold, he is in the desert. He's at Ijesha. He's at Ikotu. He's in Rome. He's in Auchi. He's where? Go not forth. Behold, he is in the secret chambers. Believe it not. He says, this is how you will see him. Listen, These things are written and spoken by Jesus, but not too many people catch it. This is how you will know where he is. This is where you will identify where he is. For as the lightning cometh out of the east and shineth even unto the west, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. And he added, for wheresoever the carcass is, there will the eagles be gathered together. This God is too much. See, he said, anytime they point, say, is there here now? He said, don't believe it. This is how to identify you. Then identify where God is. Listen, bride. Hey, can everybody listen to me? Listen very well. Listen very well. This God is too much. Amen. It is this knowledge that makes us speak the way we speak. Talk the way we talk. If you kill me now, I'm going to heaven straight. In fact, an angel will, in fact, seven angels will come and carry my body. Listen, church. Hallelujah. He said, as the light that is talking about the sun that shines, where does it rise from? And where does it set? In the west. Listen, church. The light there is the light of the gospel. We sang a song, Jesus, the light of the world. Jesus is the light of the world. Now, the gospel has started from the Middle East. And watch the seven star messengers, their positions. Their position as the light was traveling, as they were collecting like a relay button from Paul, moved like that, came down to England, moved on like that. Finally, in the seventh church age, it landed and set at the end in the West, in America. That is where the light finally ended. In the hand of the seven church age messenger, we are in the West. He said, for where the carcass is, that is the eagle's foot. The eagle's foot was with Apostle Paul. The eagles followed him. When it moved on and on and on to Irenaeus, to Martin, to Columba, to Martin Luther, to John Wesley, and now to William Branham. Anywhere the light went, the eagles in that age, they gathered there. Hallelujah. For that is where the light is. Wherever the cackle is, there the eagles will be gathered together. They were gathering around these light bearers. Until we come to the west. For that is where the day ends. The day of redemption ends there in the west. Then, when the gospel finishes with us, we go in the rapture. Where does it go again? The next morning, you see the sun again coming up in the east, in Israel. Now, the rapture will take place and the gospel will come back to Israel. That is where you identify where God is. Stop saying, following me to my church. If you want to see Jesus, Jesus is not in bride assembly. Jesus is not in bride assembly. Oh, Jesus is in the message of the hour. That is where he is. Not in any address, anywhere. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. The gospel turns. And the end of that gentle dispensation comes. Which are, in the course of our study, we have a reason to go back to the book of Daniel. Just as we take the book of Revelation, the book of Daniel is also a complete book of Revelation. We will take it again from chapter 1 to the last chapter, and you will see salvation displayed there to the core. See the program of God confirmed in the book of Daniel. Daniel had the privilege of receiving that divine agenda that slots us in the Gentile church age between, he was given 70 weeks, 69 weeks completed, and then the gospel cuts off from the Jews, and then the 78th week is hanging. I'm telling you about Daniel chapter 9, the 70 weeks that was given to him between the 69th week and the 70th week is the Gentile church age. where God suspended dealing with Israel to come and get a wife for himself from the Gentiles. When it is completed, he goes back to the east to start the last week that had been suspended when the gospel came to us. We will take it again for those who have ears to hear and learn something, to have a reason to remain saved in this age. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.